Good afternoon, children. Today we are discussing about Democratic National Revolution, 17th, 18th, 19th centuries, 9th class, 27-6-2020. So the first question is, first of all, we are discussing about assignment test. First question is, what were the main ideas of thinkers which were significant establishment of a new form of government? Children, what were the main ideas of thinkers and which were the significant to the establishment of new form of the government? So here, philosophers, the first of all we are discussing about that in the philosophers like Rousseau, John Locke, and then and previous and different types of thinkers are there. And first of all, and in that, and as per our lesson, and in that, the number of the philosophers and those are not at think or those are not discuss in outside, because and those are in a very secret manner, and those are discussing, and then their ideas and their views and views are they never say to others. They share themselves afterwards. They written a different types of books, because at that time the government those are completely and criticized to the government, and at that time John Locke. The first of all, John Locke said that, and here an equal loss and then equal loss, and another one is opportunities for all. These two and important and things are equal loss, means loss are used for all of them. Second one is opportunities for all, and all are equal in the eyes of the law. And these two were proposed by John Locke. Next, and second one, and Rousseau said that. And Rousseau and said actually, and he written one of the and book and that was Social Contract. In the Social Contract, and he mentioned that the first of all, and he mentioned representatives. He given more priority and for people representatives. People representatives. So first of all, and what is that? And here means then John Locke said that equal loss, and another one is opportunities for all. And then Rousseau said that, and he written Social Contract book. He mentioned that people representatives means the representatives elected by the people directly. Without representation, there is no meaning of the government. The first time proposed by Rousseau.
Is it right? But on that time, the most of the and kingdoms are the monarchy system, and those were completely opposed by them. That's why where they discussed in saloon and as well as in coffee centers. They discussed in saloon and then as well as the coffee centers. Then that's why, and because those are completely opposed to the government. Next question. Second question. What would happen if all people were not equal? Before law, and some had special privileges. Like right to kill others, yes, kill. Yes, kill. Here the second question is, what would happen if all people were not equal before law and some had special privileges like right to kill others? Already I said that about, and this our lesson is in the time of 17th, 18th and 19th century. At that time, most of the, it's a total, the world under controlled by the king. Or the different dynasties were ruled by the world, especially in the Europe. In the Europe, and in that time, most of the and kingdoms were under controlled by the kingdoms, under controlled by a ruler. Then, when those are implemented different types of rules and regulations, if those are not and not favor of the public, and there was no they never and criticized by, means any type of person was not criticized to them. If those are criticized, then automatically those are completely punished by the king. And then here, and important two things are completely, and first of all, we are remember here. The number one, not equal right before law. Means as per the nowadays in modern governments, then and laws aren't used for all. Laws are not, those are not making for a person, a family. It is used for all at present. But on those days, events, what is that called? And some of the laws are completely, and those are making for only a few of the persons or few of the families. Is it right? Next. And then here, means already mentioned one of the and important, if all people were not equal before law, then here the first of all, the if the people were and not equal, then automatically and then the society divided into two parts. Okay, means what were those, and on that time, means as per the 17th and 18th century, then here the higher class people, lower class people,
means here poor and rich people are the relatives of the king and other adversaries. Next, and then and one more important thing is here that and most of the people are completely those are getting lot of and problem. And which type of and problem? There was no equality, right? And third one is here there was no fundamental rights at present. What we are utilizing fundamental rights, and then on that time they never utilize any type of and fundamental rights, right? Next, here fundamental rights, are and not utilized, means here not utilize the fundamental rights. And then one more important thing is a few of the persons means who are and lot of and powers are who are the relatives of the king, who are the rich people, right? Rich people, they can kill to the lower class people, or and complete upper class people had a right to kill the lower class people. Then at that time the persons who were defeated in the hand of the enemies, and those were and some of the means what is that one, soldiers were killed by the king. Means this type of and whether this type of means one type of opportunity sorry then this type of one thing was there, and then automatically and then 17th and 18th and 19th century they had completely utilized it in the Europe. And then third question, yes, third question, what is taxes? Here the taxes are completely and collected, means on that time the Europe there are two type of taxes they collected. One is tax on the agricultural land. Next, that means agricultural land means the what, then what is that one, the farmers and other people are they must pay and completely and those are the tax. Tax, those are its governments and collected two type of taxes. The first one, they collected taxes on agriculture land, and then agriculture land and automatically, and then other and people also paying two type of taxes. What are those? They should pay and tax to the government, and then those are paying tax to the church. Then here, then when those are paying the taxes. Taxes, 1/10 of the tax and tax and completely they must pay and they and taxes and to the church. Means then directly or indirectly those are completely and following, and means those are completely it is relevant to the religious purpose. So this is completely it is called as a religious tax. It is a tax as for religion or church. Next, fourth question. Who was Giuseppe Mazzini? Yes, already know about it. The Mazzini belongs to Italy. So then Mazzini was one of the revolutionary. He was one of the revolutionary person. He was first of all one of the revolutionary person. And then second one, and he established Young Italy. It was a completely secret organization. He was one of the revolutionary. The first time one organization, secret organization, started by the Mazzini. Then and he started on Young Italy below 40 years, and youngsters are young youth, and completely joined in them secretly. Those are spread at this unification of Italy. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.